Well, hello everybody. It's great to be back with you. We've had quite a long break in our series of podcasts due to the coronavirus and just all the various events and the shutdowns and all that's related to that. But I'm really excited to share these next four podcasts with you. Just give you a little bit of background. We've been talking about messengers, master builders, and the spirit and the power of Elijah. And in some of the other, even though it's been a while, in some of the other podcasts, we spoke about messengers, and then we spoke about master builders, and we spoke about the times that we were living in. And now we're going to finish up this series with these next four podcasts, this one and three to follow, on the spirit and the power of Elijah. Just to give you a little bit of an update, what we'll do after I complete these four on the spirit and power of Elijah, we'll take a break on our podcast because we'll now be studying the Eternal Purpose Church class, and in September we'll be starting together the Forerunner School, and we'll be working on that. And so we'll probably supplement some with some podcasts throughout that, but primarily there'll be notes and audios and videos that we hopefully will be able to get to you to have access for that. So anyway, I want to finish up though in this series, The Messengers, Master Builders, and the Spirit and the Power of Elijah. Actually, what I'm going to be doing in this these four podcasts, I'm drawing this from session five in the Forerunner School, the first class in the Forerunner School, which is called Understanding the Forerunner Call. This is session five on the spirit and the power of Elijah, and I'll break it up into four different 10-15 minute podcasts to make it easy for you to listen to. So anyway, let's get started. I want us to start. We're going to talk in this one about the importance of the spirit and the power of Elijah. For messengers and master builders, it's very important that we are anointed with the spirit and the power of Elijah. Let's just read the scripture verse that we've used throughout, and it's our theme verse for our church and for life school as well. It's from Luke chapter 1, verses 16 and 17. Let me just read it. And he will turn many, this is speaking about John the Baptist, he will turn many of the sons of Israel back to the Lord their God. It is he who will go as a forerunner before him, before Christ, in the spirit and power of Elijah, to turn the hearts of the fathers back to the children and the disobedient to the attitude of the righteous, so as to make ready a people prepared for the Lord. Now let me just explain a little bit about the forerunner call in the context of messengers and master builders. We've been talking about messengers and master builders, and I think my belief is that each and every one of our life school mentors is a messenger slash master builder, or you wouldn't be a part of the team. God has chosen you sovereignly. The forerunner call, I would say, would be a little bit of a wider circle. If you think of the one big circle as the church, you think of a smaller circle as the call of forerunners within the church, and then even a smaller circle within that of messengers and master builders. And so when I speak of forerunners in the context of this series, I'm really speaking of messengers and master builders. It's very important that they be anointed with the spirit and the power of Elijah. So let me make about 3 points about the spirit and power of Elijah before we talk a little bit about its importance. one, if you think of the term forerunner, or in the terms we've been using, messenger or master builder, what you realize that those are functional terms. In other words, the idea of messenger or master builder or forerunner describes the function of those called to that task. And whereas the spirit and the power of Elijah is not so much the function, but the empowerment to accomplish that function. So that's the distinction. Forerunner, messenger, master builder, that's the function. If you're a messenger, that's what you're called to do. But you need the empowerment of the Lord on that. And that's where the spirit and the power of Elijah comes in, because that's the empowerment upon forerunners, upon messengers, upon master builders. So that's the first point. The second point about this is about the spirit and power of Elijah. I want to make sure everybody understands we're not talking about the reincarnation of the prophet Elijah. You know, he was caught up to heaven, so he didn't die, but it's not Elijah himself coming back. In other words, John the Baptist operated in the spirit and the power of Elijah, but John the Baptist was not Elijah reincarnated. Elijah or John the Baptist operated in the same anointing or the same mantle that was on Elijah. And that'll be the true for us as we operate in the spirit as end time messengers and master builders in the spirit and power of Elijah. It will be an anointing upon our lives. And so that's the second point. The third point I want to make is that when we talk about the spirit and power of Elijah, we're not talking about the Holy Spirit over here, say on the right side, and the spirit and power of Elijah here on the left. What we're talking about is as an aspect or a function or a mode of the Holy Spirit operating through the messenger and the master builder. So we're not talking about a totally different spirit where everybody has the Holy Spirit and messengers and master builders have the Holy Spirit and they have a separate spirit called the spirit and the power of Elijah. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about the empowerment with a specific mode or a specific gifting given by God to accomplish a very specific function. So it's important that we understand that. It's something like, you know, we all know, thinking of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, we all know that some people might move more in the gift of healing than others. That some might move more in the gift of prophecy of others. So there are different functions, different modes, different giftings, but it's still the same Spirit. And so I wanted to clarify those three things before we begin to talk too much about the importance of the Spirit and the power of Elijah. But now let's talk about that. Let's talk about the importance of the Spirit and the power of Elijah. There are basically four passages of Scripture, and I'm not going to turn to all those, but there's four passages of Scripture that speak about the Spirit and the power of Elijah being upon end-time messengers or being upon forerunners. The first one is Malachi chapter 4, verse 5 and 6, where Malachi writes in his book that I will send you Elijah before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. So it talks about sending Elijah, again, the anointing of the Spirit and the power of Elijah. The second one is the one we mentioned a minute ago, Luke chapter 1, verse 16 and 17, talking about forerunners who will be anointed with the Spirit and the power of Elijah. Now, forerunner, in this passage, the word forerunner only appears in the New American, in the English versions, only in the New American Standard translation. And even that is not actually in the text, the Greek text. It is an insert, editor's insert, to help explain the function of the Spirit and the power of Elijah. And I'll come back and clarify, explain why this is important in just a minute. The third passage is Matthew 17, verse 11 through 13. This is where Jesus is saying Elijah is coming and will restore all things. And, you know, you can read more of that. There's more to it, but I don't want to take the time to do that. But he's speaking about a future coming of Elijah. Again, the Spirit and the power of Elijah, the anointing upon the church. Because John the Baptist, even though he's talking about in the context of John the Baptist has already died by this point in time. And so Jesus is speaking of another coming consistent with Malachi's prophecy about the end time spirit and the power of Elijah. And then the fourth one is from Revelation, fourth passage is from Revelation chapter 11, verses 3 through 6. Revelation 11, 3 through 6. And it's talking about the authority upon the two witnesses that will be in Jerusalem in the end times. And most people think it's probably Moses and Elijah. But here's the point I want to make with this. There's a lot more you can draw from these scripture verses in different contexts. The emphasis on this is on Elijah, the spirit and the power of Elijah. Even though all of them speak of the function of a messenger, the function of a master builder, the function of a forerunner, the emphasis is on the empowerment of Elijah. I'll send you Elijah. I'll send you in the spirit and the power of Elijah. And so the point I'm making is it's the spirit and the power of Elijah is really, really important. I think about it this way. I've encountered a number of people who have a forerunner call on their life, and I've encountered others who have the forerunner call on their life, messengers, master builders, but also have the impartation of that spirit and the power of Elijah. Well, the point is that Elijah anointing really adds an additional oomph or additional empowerment of the Holy Spirit. There's a definite distinction about that. And so the point I'm making in this podcast is it's not enough to have the call as a messenger, not enough to have the call as a master builder, not enough to have a call as a forerunner. We also need to have those calls, those functional calls, but to be empowered with the spirit and the power of Elijah. Now, in the next podcast, we'll go into the spirit of Elijah, and then the one after that, the power of Elijah, and then we'll do some other things in the fourth podcast. Actually, I have a testimony I want to share. We're running out of time in this podcast, so I'll do it. I'll begin with that in the next one. So let's just end but with an understanding that the spirit and the power of Elijah is absolutely crucial, essential for those who are called as messengers and master builders. God bless.